Welcome students, how are you? I hope you have attempted the exercise that I gave you yesterday and it was not that difficult for you. Today we will discuss the answers to that exercise and I will also explain why the preposition is used in that particular sentence. This will help you to understand the prepositions even better. So let's start with sentence number one. She learned Russian at the age of 45. With age or number of years, we use the preposition at. At 45, at 35, at the age of 20. So we use preposition at with age and number of years. The book was written by Mark Twain. If something is made by somebody, if something is written by somebody, we use the preposition by. यानी अगर कोई चीज़ किसी ने बनाई हो या वो चीज़ किसी ने लिखी हो तो उसके लिए हम by को इस यूज़ करेंगे. I'll show you the picture of the palace. Picture किसकी? Whose picture? The palace. What is in the picture? The palace. So, whenever we are explaining what is in the picture, what is in the scene, we always use the preposition of. We can only get to the camp on foot. When you are walking and you are using the word foot for walking, you always use the preposition on. On foot. By car. So if you are using a vehicle, car, bus, etc., then you will use by. And if you are using your own feet, meaning you are walking, then you will use the preposition on. He reminds me of his old history teacher. Same is the rule as it was with the picture. What is the picture about? What does he remind you of? His old history teacher. So we will use the preposition of. What are you talking about? कोई भी चीज़ जिस चीज़ के बारे में होती है अगर हम उसका जिक्र कर रहे हों तो हम उसके लिए प्रपोजिशन अबाउट करते हैं का इस्तेमाल करते हैं. वट आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट? वट इज़ ही थिंकिंग अबाउट? वट इज़ द क्वेश्चन अबाउट? बाय द एंड ऑफ नेक्स्ट ईयर वी विल हैव मेड ओवर 100,000 pounds. द एंड ऑफ द ईयर वी यूज प्रपोजिशन बाय. If we are giving a time limit that this is the time when we will finish this act, then we use the preposition by the end of the month, by next month, we will be in Murray. She always gets up early in the morning and goes to bed late at night. With morning and evening, we use the preposition in. With night and day, we use the preposition at. Morning and night and evening. In, night and day, at. I went to work on Tuesday, but I didn't go on Friday. With the names of days, Tuesday, Friday, Monday, Wednesday, we always use the preposition on. You will have to wait. He'll be with you in a minute. When we are not telling the exact time, minute, year, week, month, then we use the preposition in. When you are telling the time, he will be with you in 10 minutes. So, when you are giving a time frame, then you use the preposition in. And when you are telling the exact time, 8:30, 8:05, 5:30, then you use the preposition at. He will be with you at 8:30. Clear? You use in when you are not giving the exact time on the clock. And you use at when you are giving the exact time on the clock. Philip waited for her at the movie theater. When we are talking about a place where somebody is, then we use the preposition at. At the movie theater, at the railway station, at the hotel. He started learning English in 2005. You're using the number of the year and not the exact month and date. So we use the preposition in. You have to pay for the tickets on the day you order them. When will you have to pay for the tickets? on the day. We are very proud of this company. What is your pride about? This company. So we will use preposition of. It's very kind of you to help us. So we are separating, we are joining two parts of a sentence. So we will use the preposition to. The old man suffered from a heart attack. Suffer from. We always use the preposition from with suffer. Please write in pencil. So we use in with pencil, ink, write in ink, write in pencil, write with pen. It's about time you told him the truth. About time? Right now. Like you should do this right now. So we use the preposition about. The manager didn't take part in the discussion. In the discussion, in the conversation, in the talk. So we use in with these words. The last sentence is, he's very good at telling jokes. What is he good at? Telling jokes. He's very good at making tea. He's very good at singing. So whenever we are telling the quality of someone's quality of doing something, then we use the preposition at. I hope now these prepositions and these sentences are clear to you. If you have any questions, you can ask in the comment section. That is all for today. Allah Hafiz.